Let's look at the example of image intensity. Now, most of the time, again, if you remember our earlier work on looking at image intensities in images, mostly, in fact, an image intensity changes because we have more bright pixels or less bright pixels. So in essence, mostly, this would require us to be invariant to additive and multiplicative changes in image intensity. And most of the time, the computation we're looking at, since it's dependent on the gradient information, would be invariant, as long as at any point within the neighborhood, irrespective of the brightness at that point, the invariance or the gradients at that point are the same. So again, essentially what happens at any point in an image, as long as we are working with derivatives, we should be able to kind of compute the information, the response function, and response functions purely being dependent on the derivatives, would not care if the image intensity, the region that we're looking at, is much larger from one to the other. So in essence, what we're just repeating here is it would be invariant to any kind of intensity shift. If you add a constant, the derivatives actually still won't care. And similarly, if there was a scale again, the derivatives would not be impacted, and all of that actually still same results would appear. So this is demonstrated by, again, our example, by basically I look at the response function R, and depends on where I threshold, right? Because if I threshold at that level, and if these two points are the ones that I'm looking for, I'll still detect them. But if I choose the threshold and now somebody has scaled my intensity variations, which will impact this, then it might actually cause a problem. So then we basically would have to have an adaptive threshold that knows more about the scaling impact of the intensities in an image. But otherwise, we still should be able to find, because the shape of the response over the whole sequence should still be the same.